नमस्ते, वेलकम टू कैवल्य योगा गुरुकुलम केवाईजी। लेट्स बिगिन दिस क्लास विद वन ओम फॉलोड बाय आवर रेवरेंशियल सैल्यूटेशंस टू द डिवाइन सद्गुरु एंड द इन्वोकेशन ऑफ गणेश।
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम।
लेट्स इन्वोक लॉर्ड गणेश फ्रॉम द मूलाधारा।
ओम गंगणपतये नमः।
लेट अस रिवाइज व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड सो फार, और रिव्यू रादर व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड सो फार। वी विल चैंट ईच लाइन ट्वाइस slowly, mindfully, and then we will proceed into the fifth aspect of Shiva. Let's chant each line twice together. Let's begin.
Nidhanapataye namaha, Nidhanapataye namaha, निधनपतान्तिकाय नमः, निधनपतान्तिकाय नमः, ऊर्ध्वाय नमः, ऊर्ध्वाय नमः, ऊर्ध्वलिंगाय नमः, ऊर्ध्वलिंगाय नमः, हिरण्याय नमः, हिरण्याय नमः, हिरण्यलिंगाय नमः, हिरण्यलिंगाय नमः, सुवर्णाय नमः, सुवर्णाय नमः, सुवर्णलिंगाय नमः, सुवर्णलिंगाय नमः, दिव्याय नमः, दिव्याय नमः, दिव्यलिंगाय नमः, दिव्यलिंगाय नमः, भवाय नमः, भवाय नमः, भवलिंगाय नमः, भवलिंगाय नमः, शर्वाय नमः, शर्वाय नमः, शर्वलिंगाय नमः, शर्वलिंगाय नमः, शिवाय नमः, शिवलिंगाय नमः।
I'm sorry, let's repeat शिवाय नमः again.
शिवाय नमः
again.
शिवाय नमः
next.
शिवलिंगाय नमः, शिवलिंगाय नमः, ज्वलाय नमः, ज्वलाय नमः, ज्वललिंगाय नमः, ज्वललिंगाय नमः, आत्माय नमः, आत्माय नमः, आत्मलिंगाय नमः, आत्मलिंगाय नमः, परमाय नमः, परमाय नमः, परमलिंगाय नमः, परमलिंगाय नमः। एतत् सोमस्य सूर्यस्य सर्वलिंगगस्थापयति पाणिमन्त्रं पवित्रम्।
अगेन।
एतत् सोमस्य सूर्यस्य सर्वलिंगगस्थापयति पाणिमन्त्रं पवित्रम्। क्षेत्रम् सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः भवे भवे नाथि भवे भवस्वमाम् भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्वमाम् भवोद्भवाय नमः भवोद्भवाय नमः वामदेवाय नमो वामदेवाय नमो ज्येष्ठाय नमः श्रेष्ठाय नमो ज्येष्ठाय नमः श्रेष्ठाय नमो
वन मोर टाइम
ज्येष्ठाय नमः श्रेष्ठाय नमो
विल चैंट ऑल द थ्री टुगेदर
रुद्राय नमः कालाय नमः कलविकरणाय नमो रुद्राय नमः कालाय नमः कलविकरणाय नमो बलविकरणाय नमो बलविकरणाय नमो बलाय नमो बलाय नमो
द नेक्स्ट टू लाइन्स वील चैंट टुगेदर
बल प्रमथनाय नमः सर्वभूतदमनाय नमो बल प्रमथनाय नमः सर्वभूतदमनाय नमो मनोन्मनाय नमः मनोन्मनाय नमः अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो घोरघोरतरेभ्यः अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो घोरघोरतरेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यः सर्वशर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्ररूपेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यः सर्वशर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्ररूपेभ्यः तत्पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्रः प्रचोदयात् तत्पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्रः प्रचोदयात्
वंडरफुल And today we go to the fifth face of Shiva. So the four directions, four faces of Shiva faces the four directions. The fifth face of Shiva is on top of the Shivalinga, facing up. In other words, the other dimension, where everything becomes part of one consciousness. In that other dimension, the fifth dimension as we understand here, it based on that essence of Vedanta, essence of the Sanatana Dharma thought process. What is that essence? Ekam Sat Vipra Bahuda Vadanti Ekoham Bahushyam. In other words, there is only one truth, one consciousness that is perceived as the many. Ekoham Bahushyam means I am the one, I become the many. I am the one, I become the many. So that is what is expressed here. Here we say Isha. Isha means Lord. Ishwara, Isha, all of that comes from that Lord, the source of everything. Okay, a poetic way to refer to that source is Lord. Ishana sarva vidyanam, all knowledge owes its origin to this one source. That is why in Vedanta they say you understand as the self, you understand everything else, right? The self is the Isha, the self, the I, the supreme I. Ishana sarva vidyanam, vidyanam means knowledge. The same Isha, now Ishana, you say Ishwara. Ishwara sarva bhutanam, all the bhutas, in other words, the pancha mahabhutas, the five elements, earth, water, fire, air and space, of which this creation is made up of. Space being the container of all the rest. All of that is also Ishwara. Ishwara sarva vidyanam, all knowledge. Ishwara, Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishwara sarva bhutanam. Everything is one, that one consciousness, the self. The self is everything. What is that self? Not Sundar, Shiva, the Shiva self. So how is this chanted?
Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Once you understand the meaning and chant, it's very powerful because your mind explodes into this embracing of everyone, all knowledge, without any judgments. It embraces it into that oneness principle, the Kaivalya principle. So, listen to this once. We'll break this into two parts and chant.
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Let's chant it together.
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Now, Ishana dash SS. Whenever you see that SS means Ishanas, it becomes. It's not Ishana sarva vidyanam. There's a subtle difference in the way you pronounce it. It's not wrong, it's not the end of the world, but learn it the right way. So you can say it the wrong, incorrect way. What is the incorrect way?
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
I've broken the na and the sa, right?
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Now what is the correct way? Or the traditional way?
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Join the na and the sa together. Okay? I've just separated here for our understanding purpose. Let's chant it together. Twice.
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
I'll go slower, sorry.
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Once more.
Ishana sarva vidyanam.
Excellent. Next one.
Ishwara sarva bhutanam.
Now, here what happens is,
Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishwara,
the nam and e go together. It comes naturally. It'll come naturally. It becomes Meeshwara almost.
Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishwara, vidyanam, Ishwara.
Okay, so it all goes together as a sing song. Though it's traditionally you don't sing the Vedas, but it goes in that sing-song fashion. So we are breaking it and learning it for a purpose, and let that be for over a while. When it becomes second nature to you, the chant, after you cross the hills of memorization and pronunciation and all of that, it'll come very beautifully. So be patient. So the next line is
Ishwara sarva bhutanam. Ishwara sarva bhutanam, bhutanam.
Okay, let's chant it together twice.
Ishwara sarva bhutanam, Ishwara sarva bhutanam.
Excellent. Listen to this whole sentence once. We'll try and chant it together.
Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishwara sarva bhutanam.
Listen to it one more time.
ईशानसर्वविद्यानामीश्वरसर्वभूतानाम्।
Let's chant it together, twice.
ईशानसर्वविद्यानामीश्वरसर्वभूतानाम्।
Again.
ईशानसर्वविद्यानामीश्वरसर्वभूतानाम्।
Excellent. Then, ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर्। पति means Lord, अधिपति means Master, Owner. There's no one higher than the अधिपति. The President, the CEO of the organization is the अधिपति. So अधिपति, who? The Shiva consciousness. Brahma here represents Veda, Vedic wisdom, the wisdom of the self. The knowledge of the self is the essence of the Vedas. And so the knowledge of the self is Brahma. The knowledge of the Vedas is therefore Brahma. And that adhipati of that knowledge, the source of that knowledge, the giver of that knowledge is the Shiva that we are adoring. Ishana. When are we asking for this? See, when are we claiming he's the adhipati of Brahma? After that, Ishana, Sarva Vidyanam, Ishvara, Sarva Bhutanam. Everything is you, everything is Ishvara. And therefore, you are the Lord of all this wisdom. Acceptance of the Supreme Consciousness is the first step to realization. Acceptance of the oneness. How is this chanted? So, Brahma, Brahma gets repeated here.
ब्रह्माधिपतिर।
Now R is coming. पतिर। Why the R is coming there? पतिर at the end of the पतिर. If the word is, there are three, four words joined together. ब्रह्माधि, ब्रह्मा, अधिपति ही. The अधिपति ही and the Brahma that follows, it becomes R. The R comes there because you're joining ब्रह्माधिपति ही and ब्रह्मणोधिपति ही. You're joining them together. Along with the next Brahma. So, her followed by bur becomes r. Right? Just like her followed by per becomes f, here it is r. So, these are simple sandhis. You don't have to remember them. When you chant them, don't wonder what is this r coming in the middle. When you break them separately, you read them as brahmadipatihi. But when you join them, it becomes brahmadipatir. For those of you who chant the food prayer, ब्रह्मार्पणं ब्रह्महविः, but it is what we do it ब्रह्महविर् ब्रह्माग्नौ, because ब्रह्महविः and ब्रह्म joined together, it becomes ब्रह्महविर्. So र comes. Anyway, how is it chanted?
ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा ब्रह्माधिपतिर्.
Let's chant it together twice, the first two words.
ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्माधिपतिर्.
अगेन
ब्रह्माधिपतिर्.
नेक्स्ट वन लिसन.
ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर्.
लेट्स डू इट स्लोली ट्वाइस टुगेदर.
ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर्.
थर्ड वन
ब्रह्मा.
थर्ड वन टुगेदर
ब्रह्मा ब्रह्मा.
सो हाउ इज दिस होल थिंग गो?
ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा.
लिसन वंस मोर.
ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा.
Let's chant it together twice.
ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा.
Again.
ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा.
Very nice. So that Brahma, we ended there.
शिवो मे अस्तु सदा शिवो.
And at the end, all of this merges into that eternally auspicious state. Auspicious is a very simple way of describing the state of Shiva, the consciousness of Shiva, the being that we adore as Shiva. But let us begin with that word and let the Shiva in you guide you to greater understanding of what that is.
Shivo me astu sada shivom.
And that Shiva, that auspiciousness, your mind gets filled with that, your consciousness is filled with that auspiciousness, sada shivom, eternally auspicious, right? That is the beauty of that.
Shivo me astu sada shivom. Shivo me astu sada shivom.
Let's chant it together. It's simple.
Shivo me astu sada shivom.
Again.
Shivo me astu sada shivom.
Again.
Shivo me astu sada shivom.
Very nice. Okay, so let's chant these three lines together if we can. Each twice.
Ishana sarv,
let's do it together.
Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishvara sarva bhutanam. Ishana sarva vidyanam, Ishvara sarva bhutanam. Brahmadhipatir brahmanodhipatir brahma. Brahmadhipatir brahmanodhipatir brahma. Shivo me astu sada shivom. Shivo me astu sada shivom.
Very powerful, beautiful, auspicious mantra. This Ishana mantra is. Each one has its own energy. I hope you can feel that energy as you understand and chant. It ends with that Ishana. Everything is auspicious, everything is Mangalam, everything is sada Shiva, 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 Shiva. And in that auspiciousness, now you begin to understand the glory and the mighty of this Lingam. Right? We are coming towards the end of this chant. And this is that. Two lines, long line. It's simple.
Hiranya Bahave, Hiranya
Varnaya, Hiranya Rupaya. Now your mind is fully opened up. Mind is again a very colloquial word, but bear with me here. You open up completely and now your consciousness is in Shiva. You're in ecstasy here as you chant this. That is the beauty of these compositions.
Hiranya, 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 gold, 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 golden brilliance, all of that is embedded in that gold.
So golden arms, arms represent here the ability to embrace everything in this universe. Arms represent omnipresent, omniscience, omnipotence, everything. Because when you want to extend, reach out to somebody, arms come. And you want to hug somebody, it's arms, embracing his arms. So your Hiranya Bhagave. This golden arms. This the word arms we use because at an unconscious level we relate these things, right? Arms is all inclusive. I want to embrace everyone. Everybody is part of one. We use arms to explain that.
Hiranya Bahave.
Not normal arms, golden arms.
Hiranya Varna.
Varna is hue, color. Color, aura, the vibration, the frequency. Translated into words, his words, the knowledge that gets downloaded into your consciousness at this moment is also Hiranya. So he speaks to you in the words. So here Varna is also understood as words, but not the words the way I'm using these words and the way you are understanding. But the download happens, intuition, the voice of silence, right? It is only in the in silence, in the depths of silence, that the voice of God can be heard. Baba says this. Depths of silence. So he speaks to you in Hiranyavarna.
Hiranyavarna is that vibration, frequency, color. Again, gold. Gold signifies that ultimate beauty, joy. Hiranyarupa, the form is also golden. Golden form. So how is this chanted? See, there are no red and green and or blue. Awesome, right? So just straight line. Namo Hiranyabha. Namo Hiranyabhave Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Namo Hiranyabhave Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Let's chant it. We will break it into two parts. Namo Hiranyabhave. Let's chant it twice. Let's begin. Namo Hiranyabhave. Namo Hiranyabhave. Beautiful. Listen. Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Together. Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Again. Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Wonderful. Whole line together. Let's try chanting it together. Namo Hiranyabhave Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Again. Namo Hiranyabhave Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya. Beautiful. And it continues. Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye. Namo Namaha. Namo Namaha is salutations again and again. So the Hiranya continues here. Hiranya Pataye. So this gold, we are saying you are the source of even that gold. Here the word gold, Hiranya, is used for abundance of all kinds. Abundance in knowledge, abundance in riches and wealth, and abundance in every element possible. In every dimension possible. Abundance, Hiranya abundance is the ultimate abundance of all kinds. And He is the Lord of that. Because from that consciousness, everything evolves, right? All the five elements evolve. So all abundance is attributed to that. So there is no lack, there is no mindset of lack of something here. When you go into this mindset, you just lose yourself in that abundance. There's no asking here. Hiranyapataye. Let's chant it together. The first word. Hiranyapataye. All straight lines here. Then comes Ambika Pataye. Ambika is used here. And I mentioned the meaning, spouse of Ambika. I didn't have space to explain what Ambika means, but simply understand Ambika as the energy of creation. Ambika is the mother. Amba means mother. Comes from Amma, all of that. Amma, Ma, mother, all of that comes from Ambika. Amba, Ambika. Ambika means the mother aspect. The source of creation. That is, the spouse of that source of creation is Shiva consciousness. How do we understand this? Is the Shakti principle of Shiva is the motherly aspect which creates all of this. And therefore, we say motherly because of the potential to create something. Only that mother energy of mother has that, right? So mother energy is attributed. And it says spouse of Shiva. In other words, he is the background that supports that as well. The ability to create for the Shakti comes from him. It's no he and she here. Don't get confused in sexism. It's not about male and female and all of that. But understand this as an analogy of the lioness is the mother for her cubs. The source of their energy comes from the lioness. She is the one who feeds them. She is the one who nurtures them, right? But then the lion goes and hunts food and brings it to the cave so that the lioness eats that. And with that nutrition, she nurtures the cubs, right? So the lion is the pati of the lioness. The lion doesn't directly nurse the cubs through the lioness. So that is the idea here. the spouse of Ambika is Shiva and Shakti together. It can never, these energies can never be understood as separate. No female and male separateness. It's all merging into the Hiran Ambika Pataye. Uma Pataye. Uma is, now that you have created, there is an awakening. Uma is the goddess of dawn. A very beautiful name, a very beautiful energy comes from Uma. Uma, goddess of dawn. That dawn signifies awakening of consciousness. That awakening of consciousness, the Lord is again, the Shiva consciousness is what causes that awakening. Linked to Sadhyojata, the awakening into that new consciousness. So Uma Pataye, he's also the source of that awakening. Pashu Pataye, Pashu here is creation. All beings, all matter, everything. Pashu, animals, creation, Lord. In other words, this body would have been just an inert piece if not for consciousness. Consciousness is what brings it alive. So consciousness is the pati of this Pashu. Pashu meaning the body. That is what it means here. That creation by itself would have been inert. Matter would have been inert. There would have been no intelligence. But consciousness is what creates the intelligence. Consciousness is what orchestrates this universe, which is otherwise sometimes understood as randomness. But even that randomness, even that chaos in the cosmos, is the source of all that, is an intelligence that is consciousness. Pashupati, Lord of creation. Again, how is all this chanted?
Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye Namo Namaha. Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
So Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye, let us chant this together, simple and straight. Let's chant it together.
Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye.
Don't go ye up, okay, not yet.
Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye.
Let's join the first three.
Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye.
Let's join Hiranyapataye, and Ambika becomes Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye. So all that will come with practice. Right now, even if you separate it, Pataye and Ambika, it's not wrong.
Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye.
Again.
Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye.
Again.
Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye.
And the last three.
Pashupataye Namo Namaha. Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
Let's chant it together.
Pashupataye Namo Namaha. Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
Since I chanted very slowly, I tend to drag that Namaha, but don't make that as a habit. Okay. So such is the beauty of this stanza, and I think we're going to stop with this, but then let us chant this together, because this is the state of ecstasy. After worshipping all the five Ishana, then you're lost in this ecstatic state where everything is gold, 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 gold. So how is this chanted? It's a beautiful chant. It's worth learning just this alone and closing your mind and losing yourself in this consciousness.
Namo Hiranyabhahave Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
Beautiful. Are you ready to try it? Try and get your breath somewhere in the middle. All right, let's take a deep breath. Let's try this. Three times. Breathe in.
Namo Hiranyabhahave Hiranyavarnaya Hiranyarupaya Hiranyapataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
One mistake that we might tend to do is Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye. We might say ye ye, but it is Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye. Okay, so that's the beauty in that chant when you do that. So remember, it's Ambika Pataye and Uma Pataye. Okay, two more left. Let's breathe in.
Namo Hiranya Bahave Hiranya Varnaya Hiranya Rupaya Hiranya Pataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
One last time, and let's end this class in this beautiful, auspicious note.
Namo Hiranya Bahave Hiranya Varnaya Hiranya Rupaya Hiranya Pataye Ambika Pataye Uma Pataye Pashupataye Namo Namaha.
Everything begins and ends in Shiva consciousness. Thank you for allowing me to teach this wonderful upasana. Thank you for joining the class. Let's end the class with one Om and three Shantis.
Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.